My daily practice, I'm a visual artist working mainly with installations. I come with, from a background as a, in theater and dance as a scenographer. I was very inspired by the moving body, let's say. Then later on I moved more into installation art, where the visitor takes an important role, not only as in his experience but also as an image for the other visitors. So he becomes a co-actor, if you want. I started as an industrial designer, so there I got kind of more a technical background into in Antwerp, Belgium.
Sorry, so you're originally from that?
I'm Belgian, yeah.
Okay.
Living in Norway at the moment. So I come more from an artistic family with a father as a painter and more creative people in the family. I think the creative part was already there, and originally I intended to go to the academy, but it was disadvised. And afterwards, I think I was very happy that this industrial design really opened up, made me discover new materials than the traditional paint and plaster, and made me work with really contemporary, not only materials, but especially also technologies. And this camera, this recording device, these are really the daily things we are confronted with, we are communicating with, we are living with. So that's actually the material I like to use to work with. The school next door was the fashion department and the academy, the Royal Arts Academy. The presentations they had were more free and more up to date, I found. I think industrial design is there's so much parameters to take into account. I especially had a hard time with the idea that, or the question, like, how can we create new needs for the consumer? That for me was totally inappropriate, and that I really wanted to get away from. I ended up in art. I mean, maybe art is the most open environment where I can function in. I could also ended up in a research environment in a more technical or psychological, you know, university department or something, which can be equally interesting. For me, it's not so important even if we have to define this as art or not. I think this question is always being posed again, and it's a good exercise, but from the moment you define something, you limit it. So I looked for an environment where I could be free to start with I often start with very concrete concepts, but I like to have enough freedom to then, in the materializing of this concept, the reality is most of the times much more rich and much more there are other layers in the project.